This is Why Chain Part 3. So make sure you did Parts 1 and 2. So, again, we don't want this. So we're just going to fold that over and pretend it didn't happen because this is just practice. Boom. Okay. So I'm just going to ignore the mistake and learn from my mistake. So now, in the parallelogram, you're going to put a bunch of parallel lines that are super close together and maybe even touching in spots. That doesn't mean I want them to crisscross. I want them to be parallel to the sides of your parallelogram, and they should be super close together so that they almost look like they're shaded in. Super close together. Super close together. So here's what I don't want. Crisscross. No, 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 no. Keep them parallel to each other. They should not cross each other. So just about in all of the Zentangles are these patterns. There's never any crisscross. They always go alongside each other and end before they cross. So keep these lines super close together and parallel to the sides, going in the same direction as the sides. All right, I'm going to finish all of mine on pause. You should too. So here's another mistake that I could easily see some people making is see how they aren't touching the top or the bottom. It's okay if they're not like perfectly straight, but what you want to do is make sure you go all the way to the top. Don't cross the top, but go all the way to the top so that there's not a gap. Right? So keep these lines going in the same direction, super tight. Again, it's okay if they touch in spots. That's all right. But if I have a gap, I'm just going to go in and fill it with lines that are parallel. So now you're ready for the shading. The first thing you're going to do is shade the tops of your Y where they go under. Notice how I'm over here in the lines that I just drew and on the white spot of the Y, and I start dark and then I gradually go light. So now I'm going to do this side. So I'm doing the tops, and we're doing this in pencil, by the way, so that if I accidentally get it in the middle part where I don't want it, I can erase. Go all the way to the edges, start dark, gradually go light, and I'm even shading over here on the lines, those parallel lines that I was talking about. So I'm going to do this next one. Again, I'm going to have my shading be parallel to this line, but where it goes under. So this is going on top, so I don't put the shading there. I put where it goes over here. So now I got one on the other side. So I start dark, going parallel, and I'm going under, not on top of the part that sticks out, but I go under. Now I gotta do one more on camera. So again, this is on top, so the part that goes under is what is receiving the shading. Got this side too. All right. Now, I am going to finish one, two, three more off camera. Okay, so now I have the two sides that go under the Y shaded. So now the center post, let's start on this one. This goes under right here. So this is on top and this goes under. So now this gets shaded. And then I'll work my way back up. So it was harder to understand this one because there's not anything below it, because that's the edge of my paper, but it does go underneath. It's tucked under. So it goes from dark to gradually lighter. So everywhere this stem goes down and under, I'm going to add some shading. So I start dark, going parallel to the line that I am echoing, and then I go lighter with just less pressure. Press hard, press light. Clean up on the edges. So here, this is going under this, so it gets shaded. So I'm going to finish these two off camera and then come back and show you one last step. Okay, one last step is to put a thickness to it. So you can see I chose this side to appear like it's got a little thickness to it. And here, this is a little thick. It's a little thick. So that there is an edge to it, so it makes it even more dimensional. So I'm going to draw a line that is parallel to the first curve that I made, but it's going to be pretty skinny. And then I'm going to shade that in. You don't want this to be very thick at all. See, it's a lot thinner than my pinky. So, when I am done, it should look like this. Don't make this last bit too thick. I think I want a little thick right here. So you can always do things in pencil first and then go over them in marker if you are afraid that you might make a mistake like I am. I did, but I will tell you, it's hard to draw and look at what you're doing through the camera lens. And sometimes I'll make mistakes. So we'll zoom out so you can see it from a little farther away. There you go. There's the Y chain.